Iggy Pop est un personnage à multiples facettes. Ultime figure culte de la musique Destroy, il a également fréquenté les cimes du défunt Top 50 avec In the Death Car, un morceau qu'il chantait pour la bande originale du film de Kusturica, Arizona Dream. Iggy Pop sera en concert au Zénith les 3 et 4 novembre, mais pendant 6 minutes, il est là avec nous, James Osterberg, mieux connu sous le nom de Iggy Pop.
Hey, hello, this is Iggy Pop, and you're watching Faxo. So have a good time.
Iggy Pop a débuté avec les Stooges à la fin des années 60 avant de devenir solo artiste. Depuis, il passe de nightclubbing en Arizona Dream, brouillant les pistes. Ami de David Bowie, il se proclame American César, vit au Mexique et s'affirme comme le dernier poète de l'Amérique du cauchemar.
The time I thought the first time I'd seen it was an article by a right-wing columnist saying America's falling apart and all these terrible things are happening. Where is our Caesar? He was serious. He wanted a Caesar. A lot of people in America want one. They want somebody to come in and throw out the foreigners, lock up the blacks.
People of America.
Every guy's dream in America. To sit in front of his TV set with the remote and a couple of beers and some babe, you know, going, yeah, get me this, do that. You know, the idea to, if I was Caesar, I wouldn't work. I'd watch football all the time, and it's sort of a very kind of a silly aspect to this. But it's also very powerful, and it's also very real and not a game in our society, because power and money are the name of the game. '68 was the first time they put me in jail. I was playing in a town called Romeo, Michigan, and I got arrested for indecent exposure by the Michigan State Police and put in Jackson Prison. It was very unpleasant. I think other than that, I always feel a constant censorship of commercialism, which is a more subtle form of censorship, because I don't think our society is really very free. Things are changing. There are more dark people in the street, and that scares these people with the lighter skin. These are old animosities, and the there are many people in America who would like to preserve their comfort, their material and social comfort, at the expense of justice. Something was in me, it had to come out. I started getting wild. All right. And I think they're willing to do almost anything, to the point of fascism, for that. So I think it's a very, very delicate situation right now. When the song Louie Louie came out, just because people thought it might be dirty, it was investigated by the FBI. And J. Edgar Hoover gave memos to all his agents, and they played the song on different speeds. And they would write memos saying, the scientific department has examined this record and the laboratory cannot figure out what they're saying.
I met him in 1972. Was the year, Maxis, Kansas City, and it was a hell of a night. I mean, it was myself, Lou Reed. We'd never met each other, any of us. So we were thrown together at this one table. It was myself, Lou Reed, and Iggy Pop at one table. It was a very strange night.
I met Bowie and Lou Reed about the same time. Same time, about 1970, in Maxis, Kansas City, hanging around the back room, which was a bar in New York City where Andy Warhol's crowd of starving actors would hang out. The reason everybody hung out there was because Andy Warhol didn't pay his people any money. He would just pay you in free dinners. If you were one of his people, you could go to this restaurant and eat all you could eat and drink. And he had a credit card, he'd pay for it.
The life we live is tricky, tricky. I love my home and my family. Who's
friend to me, particularly right now. I think about it in a more real way now than I did when I was, say, in my 20s. Although it almost happened many times when I was in my 20s. And I think that to have an honest look at the fact that life is something that actually has a beginning, and then it happens and it has an end. And that physical life has a certain shape to it that helps you to visualize it for what it's worth and try to do something with it and try to be aware of what's happening to you instead of just being some poor idiot constantly just reacting to whatever comes along. Felt that I was at all decadent. I would consider much the bulk of the popular music that gets pushed into the mass as very decadent.
I am talking to myself.
Ambition.
This is the impression I get from looking
at the television.
Make
better music.
Set. America is
live life in peace, and then
right down to the job.
Die.
Les pop-rappeuses sont de retour.